Aloha CNHBs! My name is Abigail Jensen and I serve you all as your CNH District Secretary for the 2023 to 2024 term. In this video, I'm going to be breaking down the Club Monthly Report Form, or MRF. This document is a Google Sheet that is used by clubs to report on all kinds of information, such as service hours, member recognition, elections information, fundraising data, and more. It is vitally important to complete this form with the utmost accuracy in order to report accurate data to the district. Your division may have an earlier deadline, but club MRFs are due on the 5th of every month at 6 p.m. local time to your respective lieutenant governor. It is their job to relay this information onto the district level to allow clubs and members to be recognized and for us to track progress towards our various district goals. The MRF has many different tabs, which I will be going over in this video. The first tab is the Instructions tab. This tab provides a description of how to complete the MRF on a monthly basis and is not meant to be edited. However, there are a couple of important things to note. First of all, there are several protected cells in this tab and throughout the entire MRF. Do not worry though, these cells aren't meant to be edited and are protected for a reason. Also, be sure you are using the correct terms MRF by seeing if the top and bottom of the sheet are filled in with this royal blue color. Unless your division uses their division colors on MRFs, this color will indicate that you are using a MRF for the 2023 to 2024 term. Next, we will be going through the Club Info tab. This tab should be completed at the very beginning of the term and asks general questions about the club, such as name, number, region, and division. If you are unsure of any specific information, be sure to reach out to someone in your club for support, or, in the case that a question doesn't apply, leave it blank. Also, be sure to not delete any cells, as that can mess up the formulas in the MRF. The next section of this tab, titled Club Officers and Advisors, will ask for the names of people serving in different club positions. Again, if the MRF lists a position that your club doesn't have, feel free to leave that cell blank. The last section of the Club Info tab asks general questions about the club, most of which ask for a specific number value that can be inputted, or a yes/no that can be selected with the drop-down menu. If you need assistance collecting this information, you can always reach out to your past club secretary, president, or an advisor. This tab in specific uses a lot of data for other parts of the MRF and the annual achievement report, so be sure that all of the information inputted is correct. We will now be breaking down the Club Roster Directory tab. This tab should also be completed at the very beginning of the term and updated when new members join the club. Information at the top about the club, division, and region will transfer over from the Club Info tab, which will also occur for many other tabs in the MRF. The tab will then ask you to input the names and contact information for all club advisors, as well as to indicate whether they are faculty or Kiwanis advisors. Next, you will be including the information for the members of your club, where it will ask for their names, any positions they may hold, contact information, any club committees they may serve on, graduation year, member ID, mailing address, city, and their dues paid status. For club level members, it's most important to know their position, graduation year, and dues paid status, but be sure to include all of the necessary information for the officers of your club. It is up to your club for how you may sort the members on this tab. However, I recommend arranging them by grade level, so when it is time to add incoming freshmen after club rush season, it won't disturb the positions of the rest of the members. It is important to note that the specific order of the names on this tab will transfer directly to the service record and MRP tabs, which is why it is so important to not disturb the current order of the names even as more members are added, since it will not accurately reflect their service and recognition data after rearranging the order. Let us now move on to the next tab, the service record. This tab should be updated every single month with the information from the projects done in the respective month before. For example, for the August 5th MRF submission, I would make sure to include all the projects done in the month of July. This tab does require a lot of work, which is why it's sometimes completed by a vice president of service or a club committee. The names and dues paid status of all members will transfer over from the club roster directory tab. For each project held or participated in, it will ask you to record the event name, date it was held, and then indicate which members earned a certain amount of service. Total service per project and per member will automatically be calculated. For this tab, be sure to indicate not only projects held by your club, but also any division level or inter-club projects members of your club participated in, since this is how they can receive credit for those efforts. Following this tab is the Member Recognition tab. The Member Recognition Program, or MRP, is a district-wide automatic program that rewards members for their participation in Key Club. There are four different levels: Bronze, Silver, Gold, and Platinum. The guidelines for MRP can be found on the CNH CyberKey by going to Recognition, then Member Recognition Program. This tab should be updated on a monthly basis. For example, for the August 5th MRF submission, I'd make sure to include all data from the month of July. This tab does require a lot of work, which is why it is sometimes completed by a vice president of membership or a club committee. For this tab, you are going to indicate which requirements were completed by the different members of your club. Most requirements are in regards to attending different types of events, such as training events, Kiwanis family events, etc. Other requirements are about articles and visuals, chairing events, positions held, or even fundraising. Be sure to check out the MRP guidelines for in-depth breakdowns of each of these requirements. If you have any questions about MRP, be sure to reach out to Member Recognition Chair Chloe Hartanto at mr.chair@cnhkeyclub.org. To indicate completion of a certain requirement, indicate X in the leftmost column of any specific requirement in a member's given row. If a member fills up all the requirements for a specific section, it is not necessary to add more, since it is the maximum that they can earn. The service hours and dues paid requirement, which need to be completed for any given level, are automatically transferred from the service record tab. MRP is calculated from April 1st to January 31st, so be sure to double check all of this information to ensure that the members of your club are properly recognized. The next tab we will be going over is the Club Elections tab. This tab should be completed at the very beginning of the term, and it is only filled out once. It is to report on officers who are elected between January to March 2023 and are currently serving in the 2023 to 2024 term. This tab will ask you to include some club and meeting information, contact information for your primary faculty and Kiwanis advisors, and the names, graduation years, and contact information for all of the officers serving on your club board. We will now be going over the Annual Achievement Report tab. This tab is automatically completed based on other information that is inputted into the MRF. This tab helps calculate your Automatic Achievement Report, or AAR, score. AAR is an international points-based recognition system that is used to measure club activity. The score is from 0 to 190, with two levels of recognition: Distinguished Clubs, with a score between 148 and 177, and Diamond Distinguished Clubs, with a score of 178 or higher. If you have any other questions, comments, or concerns about AAR, check out the information on the CyberKey by going to Recognition, then Automatic Awards. As I mentioned, this tab takes info from other tabs, which means that you only need to manually input one section to calculate your final AAR score, which is found on the very bottom. For the February 5th MRF submission, be sure to indicate whether or not you have had monthly activity on the MRF, which earns your club an additional point. No other parts of this tab require editing. The last set of tabs we will be going through is the monthly tabs. There's a tab for every single month of the year in the MRF, from April to March. For each month's submission, you will be expected to complete the tab related to the previous month. For example, for the August 5th MRF submission, you must complete the July tab, in addition to the rest of the tabs. the information at the very top is transferred over from the Club Info tab. The Monthly tab is broken down into three sections: the Data section, Project section, and Narrative section. In the Data section, it will ask if any new members paid dues in the given month, and if so, what day their dues were sent in, and the check number if it was sent through check. The District or International Officer or Committee Member and Candidate for District or International Office data will automatically fill. It will then ask about sponsorship. The other two boxes related to sponsorship automatically fill, but make sure to indicate which months you provided a program for Builders Club or K-Kids. In the Attendance section, there are various different tables. The one to the top left will ask about different meetings. In the first few rows, you will indicate the weeks where your club held general meetings and how many members were present, if your faculty advisor attended, if your Kiwanis advisor attended, if any guests were present, and if your division's lieutenant governor attended. In the next few rows, it will ask the days of any inner clubs, which will need to be indicated by the different inner club codes found below the table, board meetings, socials, or special meetings. The bottom few rows would like you to indicate what days that Kiwanis meetings or DCMs were held, and then finally indicate if members were present at those Kiwanis meetings. In the Members Relation table, indicate how many club newsletters were released and if your club held a member induction, new member training, or a meeting during a school break. In the Reports table, indicate when your club completes the Club Elections Report, which is the Elections tab of the MRF, the months where the directory is updated, and if your club submitted articles to your division. In the table to the right, indicate how your club communicated with your lieutenant governor in the respective month, if you attended the given month's DCM, Kiwanis DCM, officer training conference, and whether your advisor was present at either OTC or attended an online advisor training. Below, indicate whether non-officer members or club officers attended DECON workshops, division training events, region training conference, key leader, or fall rally, as well as how many people specifically attended fall rally. Finally, with the special events table, indicate the number present and whether advisors attended any Kiwanis special functions, club or division banquets, your division's conclave, DECON, or ICON, as well as if your club had a candidate at the last three. Project section, you will be including information about the projects held or participated in throughout the month. Again, also be sure to include division service events here to be able to get credit for attending them, and make sure that this information matches the information in the service record. For each project, list the project title, total member hours, total number of members, and indicate with an X what types of projects it was. In-depth explanations of each type of event can be found in the Club MRF manual. For fundraisers, also be sure to indicate how much was raised for service or the club, and for all projects, indicate how much funds were spent on the project. Finally, for the narrative sections, include a one-paragraph-long club snapshot each month on the status of the club. You can touch on things you did well, things you could improve, and anything else that you would think it would be nice to mention. In addition, record the project chairs for each project held and have them complete a 2-3 sentence reflection on how the project went to include under project snapshot. That concludes our MRF overview. Thank you all so much for watching. To get access to additional resources, such as the Secretary Series videos breaking down each month's submission, the Club MRF manual, and the MRF Q&A form, be sure to join the Secretary's Google group. You can do this by going to the CNH CyberKey at cnhkeyclub.org, going to Resources, then Secretary, and then filling out the form to join the Google group. You're also free to contact me at dsec@cnhkeyclub.org. Thank you so much, CNH. Buzz out.